We're going to be doing four trousers for our dresses, which are A-line. So with the four dresses that we have done A-line, I'm going to be making all of those into four trousers. The first one was the designer suit in the mint green. So laying this double folded absolutely evenly, I'm going to lay the whole of the four out one on top of the other and cut the four of these all at once, as they are all one size and all identical. This is for the second of the designer suits. This is for the maroon chemise. So these are four trousers that we are cutting all on one pattern and one size. The size of this girl is a size 8 to 10. I don't actually have one of her trousers. I'm just gonna go and locate a trouser pattern that I can actually just follow to cut this on. Pattern that I'm going to use is just a very, very basic trouser, a ready-made trouser that has come with one of the ready-made suits. Not brilliantly sewn, but we're going to do our own slight bit of modifications away from this. The length and the general fitting of this is right. The only problem with this particular trouser is the crotch, for my liking, is way, way too long. So we're going to shorten that up slightly, because you don't get the hanging on trousers with that long crotch. This is the front leg that we're actually cutting at the moment. Because we're going to do the crotch a little bit shorter, the inside leg we're going to leave a little bit longer. And this is the front crotch that we are cutting. Now, like I said, this girl, she's very, very slim, so I'm going to make sure that I don't actually cut it overly wide. I use the pattern as my general guidance, but then I'm going to trim this down, because this is not the final fitting that I would want from this. I would go according to my own measurements. I'm going to even the whole of these pieces out all to exact same size. The width of the poncha at the bottom over here is it's going to be about 12 inches ready. So we've got about 13 inches at the moment. This is the outer curve of the leg, the outside leg seam that I'm putting across. I've slightly margined it in on the thigh area and then taken it out on the hip area, and again towards the waist area I've slightly curved it back in again. And on the top of the waist I'm going to slant this down slightly towards the crotch area. The distance from on the waist area over here is approximately 9 inches. And then I'm going to curve this around. The length of the crotch over here at the moment with the turning is going to be about 2 inches turning at the top, and going down is about, I'll measure it for you, but it's about 10 inches I would reckon. Maybe 11 inches. And that's the whole of my front leg pieces all cut out for 4 trousers all at once. Now the fabric is all laid out evenly, and just the few pieces that have any creases or any dints in, I'm going to just even those out as well. Just go and glance over at the time to make sure I've got adequate time. Yeah, we're on 7 minutes, so I think we should be able to cut out the back pieces within the 10 minutes. Just slightly even it out. What I will do is I will take the abstract colour so that it's more visible to you when I'm cutting you the pieces, so that it's more apparent. And we're going to be cutting the back of the trousers. I'm going to alternate this towards the other side. Allow the extra space here for the crotch. Make sure all your pieces are evened out, and also make sure that all your alignment, all your squaring is, the fabric is squared. Now, this is the back crotch area, and we're going to be making this wider than the front. Take away the excesses. Not bad for putting 4 pairs of trousers in less than 10 minutes. Yeah. I mean, a trouser is very, very simple to stitch and very simple to put. It takes absolutely no time at all. It's probably one of the simplest of garments to make, except for churidar, which is also very, very simple to make. I don't know, I have customers who come in and who constantly complain about sewing, and they request me to stitch for them. And